Children, now I am going to read the lesson again and I am going to explain you this lesson. So, listen carefully. Lesson number 2, The Tale of a Mountain, Section 1. Once upon a time, there lived a mountain which was so high that it might have been the tallest mountain in the whole world. It stood all alone in the blue sky. The plain was far below it, so it had very few friends. See how nicely the author has described. Yes, the mountain, the author feels that the mountain is the tallest mountain in the whole world and it has very few friends. Let's see who was the friends of the mountain. Only the big fluffy clouds reached all the way to its peak. See children, now this is a mountain. Okay, for example, this is the mountain which the author is talking about. Yes, and children, this is a plain. Plain. Yes, so the mountain is so high, it always looks up. Yes, the mountain always looks up. And this is a peak. This is called a peak of a mountain. So, only friend the mountain was having a big fluffy cloud. Yes, who was the mountain's friend? A big fluffy cloud was the mountain's friend. Okay, and then we'll see what happened. But what fun it was to poke its pointed peak into the fluffy middle. See how nicely the mountain and clouds used to play? Yes, the mountain used to poke. See, this is called poke. Poke. Yes, the mountain used to poke. Its peak. Children, this is a peak. And the mountain used to poke its peak into the big fluffy cloud. How nicely the cloud is described. Big, fluffy. You all know that. These are the describing words. Yes, these words are used for clouds. A big cloud. A fluffy cloud. Okay. It was fun to poke its pointed peak into the fluffy middle. It tickled them. Children, do you know what is the meaning of tickle? Tickle. Tickle. To touch someone lightly with your fingers in such a way that it causes laughter. Children, many times it happens that if you want to make someone laugh, yes, you always you use your fingers. Yes, and you tickle them. Yes, we tickle with our fingers in our friends or your siblings. In their stomach to make them laugh. Isn't it? That is called tickle. Okay. The clouds would burst into laughter. Yes, they used to laugh. Yes, they used to burst into laughter. And sometimes they would laugh so hard that they would cry. Many times it happens that when we laugh a lot, we laugh, and then suddenly we start crying. Yes, we start crying. Yes. So, the same thing used to happen with this cloud. Then, it would rain on the earth. See how nicely it has been explained. That when the cloud starts crying, it rains on the earth. Yes, one hot summer, the sun shone down so hard and long that for several days, there wasn't a single little cloud in the sky. The mountain felt very sad. See children, as we all know, the author has said that the mountain and clouds were very good friends. They used to play together. And suddenly, one day what happened? All the clouds went somewhere. And now, the mountain was missing the clouds. It was feeling alone. Finally, when it could not bear being lonely any longer, it asked the great wide sky, "Why won't you let the little ones run and play? Where have they gone?" See, the mountain is asking the sky that where are my friends? Where have they gone? Yes, I am missing them. See children, it asks the great wide sky. Wide means very big. Yes, what is the opposite of wide, you know? Wide means very big. Opposite of wide is narrow, means very small. Yes, so it asks the great wide sky, why won't you let them? Why won't you let the little ones run and play? Where have they gone? The sky replied. See what the sky replied. Listen. All my children have gone to the kingdom of winter. Where have they gone? They have gone to the kingdom of winter. Yes, which is very far from here. The sky is saying they have gone to the winter kingdom and which is very far from here. They won't come back until the end of summer. I miss them so much, the mountain said with a sigh. Children sigh a deep breath to express sadness. Yes, when you feel very sad and you say something, yes, with a deep breath, that is called sigh. For example, I'm sure you must be saying this to your parents nowadays. I am missing my school friends, Raj said with a sigh. Yes, means a deep breath to express sadness. When you express your sadness with a deep breath, that is called sigh. Okay, so the mountain was very sad and the mountain was telling the sky that I am missing my friends. Maybe I should go to the winter kingdom to visit my friends. See, the mountain wants to go and visit its friends. Yes, the mountain wants to see the clouds. Mountain wants to visit the kingdom of the winter. You are a mountain. Mountains are heavy and can't fly like clouds. See what the sky is saying. Sky is saying that you are a mountain. You are very heavy and you cannot fly. Yes, the clouds flew and they went to the winter's kingdom. We all know that a mountain cannot bend like us. Mountain cannot move. It has to stand still. Yes, it cannot move. Mountains always stay in the same place. The sky stated firmly. See, the sky is telling the mountain that you have to stand on one place because you cannot move. Stated firmly. Children, the meaning of this word is given in the right side corner in your textbook. Stated firmly means final way. Yes, the mountain said that I want to go, I want to meet my friends, but the sky said no, you cannot move. Yes, stated firmly, you must sit to study at least for an hour every day, my mother stated firmly. Children, nowadays your mother must be telling you that you have to study for an hour, isn't it? That is called stated firmly. She tells you firmly that you have to. Yes, stated firmly. The mountain became even sadder. First of all, the mountain was feeling sad because the clouds was not there. Yes, it was missing clouds. And now the sky is saying that you cannot move. You cannot fly like clouds. You have to stand on your place. Everyone else moves around and finds exciting new things. And I have to sit still. Nobody and nothing needs me. It wailed. Yes, the mountain was feeling very sad. It wailed. See children, wailed, the meaning is given in your right side corner. Wailed means crying voice. Yes, when you say something in a crying voice, that is called wailed. Now, I am going to send you a few questions. Okay? You are going to read this lesson carefully and you are going to solve a few questions from this lesson. This was section 1.